In this video, you will learn how to use, edit, and import Google Slides themes. Choose a theme. Let's say we're creating a new blank slide deck, and when you create it, there you go. On the right, you have your themes that you can choose from. I'm just gonna click down and randomly choose one of the themes I have here. So that is the route when you're creating a new presentation. If you already have a presentation, on the other hand, like we have here, click on slide, change theme, and I'm gonna choose a simple dark. There you go. Edit a theme. There are two ways to edit a theme. Either you click on slide and edit theme, or what I generally prefer to do is to click on view, theme builder, and now we're in the theme builder, and whatever we click on our theme slide here will have an effect or an impact on all of the slides, no matter what layout they have. Let's demonstrate this. Let's select this title up here, and let's say instead of this font, we're gonna have, I don't know, the Metal Mania. Yeah, there you go. So let me exit this view. So wherever we have a title on our slide, there you go, we have our Metal Mania. This time I'm gonna access it through, if only I could find it, there you go. Edit theme. What else could we change here? Let's add our company logo. This again will reflect on all of our slides. It's not gonna be the placeholder. Instead, we're gonna add a proper image. We're gonna call it, or search for, the Sub Paris logo, like so. We have access to our Google Drive. We're gonna insert it. I would like to have it up here. I'm guessing that's where you mainly have your logo. Let's have a look. Yep, there you go, on all of our different layouts, on all of our different slides. Let's head back into our theme builder for one last time, just to show you that you have different layouts. So you can make changes on specific layouts. You can, if you wanted to rename them, you can change anything on the layout. You can also go ahead and add a new layout. The way I usually do that is simply by right-clicking and saying new layout. You can duplicate it, rename it here, or you can go ahead and delete it if you don't need that anymore. Let's just quickly have a look at this here. Again, let's change this into something else. Let's use the Metal Mania. So that will reflect now on anything that has the layout that specific type. There you go. Import a theme. You can import a theme from any existing Google Slides presentation or even Microsoft PowerPoint. So head down to a slide and then change theme, import theme, and now choose whatever presentation you want its theme to be imported. Let's say we're gonna choose, not that one, let's choose another one here. Just this random one. Click on select and it gives you this selection. You say, yes, I would like to import this specific theme as it recognizes one. Now there you see that it looks very differently. Obviously this would need some tweaking now because the theme doesn't look perfect, but you can see the colors already have changed. The layouts have changed as well. That is the route of importing a theme. Now you can also kind of like copy paste a theme into another presentation. To show you what I mean, I'm going to go ahead and copy this, head into this presentation that we see, again, looks different. I'm gonna close that, we don't need that. We see how this theme here looks. Now, I'm just gonna simply paste this slide, and it asks me if I want to match the styles in this presentation or if I want to keep the original styles, which I'm going to do. That is why this slide now looks very different from this one. On a side note, check out what happens if we check the theme builder. Now, all of a sudden, we have two themes. So that is an interesting thing, or an interesting way to get multiple themes into one and the same presentation. This, the only way I've ever made this work is by copy-pasting a slide that contains another theme into your current presentation. Did you learn anything new? Then let me know what it was in the comments section below. And have you already subscribed to this YouTube channel? You haven't? Then go ahead and click on the subscribe button so that you don't miss out on any of our upcoming video tutorials.